Hello everyone, and welcome back. Today, we are in the kitchen. And I'm sure it's much louder and different acoustics. We will make it work. I have this very, very old carrot cake recipe from my mom's friend. Mary, both Mary and my mom are no longer with us, so I feel like it's appropriate that I share their beloved cake. It calls for 2 cups of sugar, 1.5 cups of oil, 4 eggs. Cups of flour, 2 teaspoons of cinnamon, 2 teaspoons of baking soda, 1 teaspoon of salt, 3 cups of shredded carrots. I strategized my nail polish for this cake. And then we finish up with 1/2 cup of nuts and 1/2 cup of as to blend the sugar with the oil. Crunching up all the sugar bits. And now that our sugar and oil has been mixed, add our 4 eggs. switch over to whisk. And although the recipe doesn't call for it, I think we should add a little vanilla extract. Now that everything is mixed together for the wet ingredient, we will add the flour, cinnamon, baking soda, salt. Teaspoons of cinnamon, 2 teaspoons of baking soda, and 1 teaspoon of salt. That's our dry ingredient. Now that our batter is mixed, we'll add the shredded carrots. Half cup of nuts. And a half cup of shredded coconut. I used the sweetened kind. Now that the carrots and nuts and coconut are incorporated, we will split the batter between two round cake pans. Now the recipe I have calls for a 9x13 greased and floured pan. I'm going to mix things up with 2 9-inch round pans lined with parchment paper with an insulation ring around the outside so the cake will raise evenly in the pan. And I like to use the Pam baking flour spread batter between the two pans. And then I'll put these into a preheated oven at 325 degrees Fahrenheit for a 9x13 rectangular pan. It says 50 minutes. So So I think we'll check these after 30. And when they come out, I'll tell you how long they actually baked. We are back with some cooked carrot cake and these 9-inch round pans took just about 50 minutes at 325. So while they cool, we can make the frosting. And for the frosting, I'm going to double the recipe listed. Paper. I have 2 bricks of cream cheese, 16 ounces total, and 1/2 cup of butter. So have some 1/2 and 1/2, some butter, vanilla emulsion, some vanilla extract, and 6 cups of powder. After the addition of powdered sugar, we have a lovely cream cheese frosting that we will frost our cakes with as soon as. So here we are, the cakes have cooled for at least 1 hour, and I'm ready to fry. I like to start out with more frosting than I'll need. So it can hang over on the edge. place the second cake. And adjust if needed. Looks good. And I've put a ton of frosting on top so that I can cascade it over the side. It's not a super firm frosting, so I will be sure to store this in the fridge. Also has cream cheese in the frosting. Bench more. And I like to clean the sides up. Thank you. nice, smooth look. And I'm not going to do anything too fancy. Good. Maybe we should try a fancy comb for the sides. Pretty good. And then for the top, I have these toasted walnuts. Sprinkle around the edge. And there we have our very own carrot cake. I hope you enjoyed this ASMR carrot cake experience with my mom's friend's recipe from the 80s. We can all thank Mary for this delightful experience. And now I'm going to put this in the refrigerator and bring it into work. Next Tuesday for my group meeting. Please take care of yourself. And I hope to see you again soon.